There's someone else. Why don't you introduce yourself? Are you afraid?
No. Why should I be afraid?
Exactly. But what are you doing in this girl's body? It doesn't belong to you. And she'd like to have it back.
So what? This container has been assigned to me. And who do you think you are talking to me like that?
All right. We'll talk about it another time. But don't get too comfortable in there, because I have a way of getting you out. You know that, don't you? If this girl strengthens her conscience, her soul will reactivate, and you'll fry.
That's what you think. And if it did happen, I'd get back in. I'm not a reptilian or one of those stupid Nordic vultures. I'm bodiless.
So you're a light being. Even better. Make my job easy. Get lost. But should you get back in, I'll be here waiting. But it's not going to happen because, well, there's something your superiors neglected to mention.
What is it? Tell me.
Not now. Next time. Rita, listen to me now. I'm going to count to six.
Wait.
No, Rita, listen to me. I'm going to count to six. By six, you wake up and everything will be fine. One, the scene around you is again a photograph. Two, you leave the photograph. Three, you're lying on a beautiful red sofa surrounded by black monitors. Four, you go back into the elevator that quickly begins going up. The elevator stops, and the doors open onto a stunning, empty beach. Five, you leave the elevator, and you lie down on the soft, warm sand. And now, relax. Relax completely. You bask in the heat of a bright, warm sun. In the splendid blue of summertime. Six, open your eyes. If this girl strengthens her conscience, her soul will reactivate, and you'll fry.
That's what you think. And if it did happen, I'd get back in.
I'm not a reptilian or one of those stupid Nordic vultures.
And who do you think you are talking to me like that?
I'm bodiless.
So you're a light being. During these last 10 years, I've carried out my research on hundreds of people of every age, sex, and social status. People who, under hypnosis, relived their abductive experiences, memories tucked away in the recesses of their subconscious. We've come to the conclusion that for thousands of years, specific extraterrestrial races have employed a program of genetic manipulation that allows them to utilize a particular form of human energy by implanting one or more alien memories. And what is this energy? We can define it with what we call the soul.
What time is it?
5:04 p.m. And you and I have a lot of work to do together.
Why original?
The good old soul, that mysterious entity that from day one we're told to be careful not to lose, not to sell, and that we must provide for its salvation. The soul, that immortal, permanent energy that many alien races no longer have or never had. An inexhaustible battery that can only be tapped through the human DNA strands.
What are you gonna tell Big Blue Eyes that she's pregnant with an alien reptile embryo?
But there's a problem. The soul's electrical voltage is infinitely bigger than the alien energy. And as of now, and I repeat now because they're still working hard on it, the aliens can't use soul energy directly because they would get burned. They can only use it through the human body because it's a trap for the soul.
She's almost in her third month. In about 20 days, they'll abduct her again to extract the fetus.
First, we have to force the light being out of her brain.
And what is it that you know that this light being doesn't?
Nothing. I was bluffing. For a reptile-shaped alien, or a six-fingered humanoid who's becoming more and more incorporeal, or for a light being who lost its body a long time ago, to survive in this dimension and have access to higher dimensions requires a lot of energy, and that's why they need ours.
Guys, remember, at 7 p.m. we have check-in for Turin flight.
Perfect, Comrade Elena.
Zurak. Davide. For the very last time, are you sure you want to do this? Are you sure? Are you sure? Are you sure?
If there are any questions, I'd be perfectly happy to answer them.
How do aliens consider human beings?
Cows to be milked. A herd to be manipulated for their daily needs.
Are you saying that the aliens just consider
yes,
us containers than to suck our soul?
Are you aware of what you're implying?
That's what the aliens tell me through the abductee under hypnosis.
Well, I have to say, after this incredibly fascinating presentation,
there's one last thing I would like to add. Many people have asked me to describe exactly how the abductions take place. I need to make it clear that in most cases, the abduction operations are carried out by terrestrial military forces who do the dirty work of picking up and bringing back home the abductee. But only after implanting their own microchip. And
Dr. Pizzo, I think that the extensive information you've shared with us is enough for one day. This subject requires a lot of time, and we still need to hear the other colleagues' presentations who, I'm sure you'll agree, have the right to their allotted time. Hmm? Another nice round of applause for Dr. Davide Pizzo.
Sometimes when I wake up, I draw these. My name's Saturnia. I was abducted, I think, by...
Right. Okay, I understand. Let's do this. Go to my website and download the test. It's a preliminary questionnaire. You'll need to fill it out before we talk. Then you come visit me at the university. To the airport.
Airport it is, sir.
See the story. Jesuit. Jesuit. That's exactly what I mean. That's one of the biggest deceits of the Hellfiends. By the fact that we study Christianity, which is Jesus Christ. The Christ.
The degeneration of the brain cells is drastically accelerated.
Check it out.
But what's strange is that your mother has started writing again. She hasn't stopped since yesterday.
Hi, Mom. It's me.
Have you got a cigarette?
Sure. What are you writing? Huh?
Agatha, what are you writing?
Nothing.
As you're probably aware, in Alzheimer patients, writing is an activity that tends to degrade over time.
Yes, I know. I also do some work with the brain. No, Mom, what are you doing?
Agatha!
Don't burn it!
Agatha, why did you do that?
Mom, it's not like you. Hey there, Zeus. How you doing, boy? Come on. Come on.
Dr. Piso, since I would like to end this nightmare, would you please sign the divorce papers?
Remember,
still haven't found the time. Too busy saving your crazy bitches from the little green men.
We're the bad ones. The ones that follow them.
Fuck you.
The ones that denounce the hierarchy.
Your beloved dean would like to inform you that they have revoked our financing. The university trustees didn't care for the can of worms you opened on TV. Talking about alien vampires as though you were discussing the weather. Thanks to you, Davide, which sloshed €1 million.
One last question, Dr. Piso. How do these beings carry out their mission?
For aliens, it's important that we're not aware of the soul.
And procreation.
And they manage that by numbing us. Media, politics, financial markets, culture.
Infiltration.
This is possible
not just by that race,
only through a mental
races.
Control program
so
that's
that.
Overseen both by alien hybrid beings and the world's true powers. What I mean is Masonic lodges, merchant banks, military research institutes, universities, and let's not forget the secret services, of course.
I'm going to have to fire you. We backed you all the way, you know that, don't you? No, I'm sorry, now it's over. You use regressive hypnosis to reprogram them neurolinguistically. All this in our industrial chemistry department.
I put up posts saying the separation.
Your experiments here are now over.
In spirit, which is subconscious, conscious, and soul.
One last thing, Davide. Leo Colli is one of our brightest chemists and physicists. Elena Fomenko is becoming a top-notch linguistic geneticist.
And these brilliant scholars are convinced not only that they were abducted, but also that I freed them.
What I'm trying to say is that you cannot keep using them with your research.
This country sucks! That brainless dickhead! She's got a microchip as big as her entire skull!
I was thinking, Davide, what about your country house? That huge room where your ex-wife used to make ceramics.
Right. Right.
Yeah?
The workroom. Sorry, isn't that where you two had a couple of extremely close encounters?
Hey, Professor. How's it going?
It's okay. Good morning,
Saturnia.
Saturnia.
Here's my test.
Yes,
Thank you.
Yes, there's proof you had some kind of an experience. But, look, there's something strange here in the dream portion.
I checked it. Everything else fits into the sample tests.
Uh-huh. Yes, but these kinds of visions don't fall into the abduction category. Okay, let's do this. Next week, I'm having a comparative group session with people who believe they've been abducted. Come. It'll clear up any doubts. Sorry. Hello? Hello? Giovanni Cervo, sure, what can I do for you?
So, address?
Torrente di Caprona, at the fourth kilometer, you'll find our red house.
Of course, fine.
See you there.
Thank you, guys. Say goodbye for me.
So, yeah, the workroom.
Leo.
Hot stuff.
Leo? Hmm? You know you're a piece of shit.
Oh, come on. Everybody knows.
Yes, I understand.
If you've never conversed with your spirit, then you don't know who it is that's talking. You've never spoken with your soul.
They were touching me before. God, it's disgusting. I don't want them touching me.
What else could I do? That alien,
they forced me to host it, to give energy to the others.
Yes, it's here. It's like some sort of reptile.
The containers don't know anything about the network.
What containers?
I'm scared. He's doing something in there.
Get rid of it. That's it. Just throw it out. That's it. Tell him you don't want it anymore.
Professor, they took me away again. It was just like the last time. I woke up in my bed and I could hear this high-pitched sound in my head, and I couldn't move, I couldn't scream. Please, answer.
Gifted people, oracles. Some people practice it. Black guards, the bodies, shamanism, stuff like that. Some people know the drugs and how to tap into subconscious. But the soul is what connects us. It's the connection between the physical and the spiritual. The subconscious and conscious is whether you recollect or remember it or not. That's all. They're fighting for our spirit and mind. The way they get our spirit and mind so they can enjoy the physical through our soul. So be a soul man. Be full of energy, like me. Sense the energy.
I was coming soul back man. From the gym.
Soul.
When I
energy.
Ran out of
protect
gas,
your protect your soul.
And I was about to call a cab, but I realized my cell phone was out of range.
Takes your soul.
Then I remembered you live nearby, so
you don't even know. He's the star.
I took a 2-mile walk through the woods. Wow. And someone was following me. An earthquake. Tomorrow's the group session.
Then line between being possessed and not being possessed. Very thin line. I say we do both. We're in between.
No, I can't, Saturnia. I'm the last person in the world who should.
We are both physical and spiritual beings.
But I'm not like your other patients.
Thank you.
decided to work with that girl.
Six.
No, I'm serious. Hurry!
You now are in a big room with black monitors instead of walls. An image appears on the monitors. An image as big as the wall. It's a picture. Can you see it?
The room has big walls and a vaulted ceiling. There are burning torches on the walls.
What is it? What's happening?
Oh my God.
But they're not telling us
about these
exorcisms.
I'm all tied up. My legs are spread apart. There's some big shadows in the wall in front of me. They all look alike.
Trying to manifest itself.
Can you see who they belong to?
Physical, sexual pleasure with you.
There's this person wearing a cloak. A red cloak.
I've had sex before.
I'm scared.
Like the story of Mary.
What is it? Jesus, is it human?
I'm also
mother.
Aroused. My nipples hurt. But I don't
like
want to be.
Flicks. You always seen some beast.
No, he's taking off his robe.
Sort of human being.
He's incredibly handsome, but he's got.
Really enjoying because the beast.
But his eyes are evil.
I try to call it bestiality.
No. He's inside me. He's moving fast.
I'm going to do a quick check.
I don't want it.
A human will never be the size of that horse. Bestiality.
Go on, sit down.
The Bible talks of man mixed with beast.
There are hands moving all over me.
Lying. The Bible
touching
talks
me
of giant.
Everywhere.
The Bible's not lying.
Oh. Oh. What is it?
Mary wasn't the only version.
It's behind him.
Not these things.
No, it's in front of me.
Davide, stop. It's the first time anyone has described something like that.
Yes, I know, but I want to hear more. Now, Saturnia, I'm going to count to three. And on three, you're going to go to sleep for a little while.
Davide.
One.
Don't do this.
Two.
Not this time.
Three. Good. Who else is in there? I know there's someone. Who are you?
Do you want a name? Hang on. Call me Hexabor. Hexabor of Ur.
Of course. The Kingdom of Ur. The First Sumerian Dynasty. Mesopotamia. There. You see, I already know something about you.
And I know everything about you, Davide Piso. Ulzam Aglitas Megif. Davide, it sounds like she's speaking Hungarian.
So?
It's the modern language that comes closest to ancient Sumerian.
And?
Wait, it seems something like... Thanks for inviting me.
Did I miss anything?
Very good, Elena. As usual, you're of great help. Not like Leo.
I missed something.
And what are you doing in Saturnia's body? You're aware, but you have no right to be there.
This container is now mine, and will be forever. As you can see, I can inhabit a body totally, and use the soul, your soul. It's beautiful.
It's not possible.
Thanks to your intervention, now I can guide my companions to complete incarnation. Don't forget, Davide, the apocalypse of St. John, and the dead will return.
And the dead will return to life.
I'm going in. Satornia, here, put this on. It's...
Satornia exists no longer. And you are the slave of your master. Exobor.
Exobor, forgive him. You talk to me, okay? I'm the only one who can help you survive in this reality. Otherwise, you haven't a chance.
Your cooperation is precious. That's why I know you'll appreciate your reward.
How's your mother, David?
You still don't know how to stop brain cell degeneration, do you?
No.
Saturnia Gota Varano. Hey, German Italic nobility. Black aristocracy. She's a countess.
Had I known?
I'm surprised at you. You made a terrible mistake for an easy fuck.
Christ's sake, Elena. What the fuck are you talking about? Do you have any idea of the mess we're in now?
I told you to stop during the hypnosis.
Since she was a little girl, Saturnia has felt surrounded by strange presences. She often has nightmares and sexual anxiety.
Stay calm, my dear. So, you are what? Some psychologist?
No. I'm a biochemist.
Shouldn't you be spending your time with test tubes and microscopes?
As
who
I was
authorized
telling
you to hypnotize a young girl who suffers from schizophrenia?
Schizophrenia? No. Saturnia is the victim of an extremely powerful alien memory that's taken possession of her. But I can still try
to... What are you doing? Experimenting on my daughter?
Bring our daughter back, Doctor. Tom. We'll give you until
one of them.
Tomorrow at 12 o'clock.
Please. No. Wait.
Otherwise, Dr. Pizzo, we'll accuse you of kidnapping.
That's not a real
kidnapping. No, of course I'll bring your daughter back, but I need you to promise me that I'll be able to continue my work with her.
How much are you asking to bring her back?
Half alien.
How much?
If you look at the Echelon Pyramid, you'll find them on the Echelon
How
Pyramid.
Much?
These exact people.
How much? How much?
Italian nobility.
How much?
Says they're 50%, 50% human and alien. They run the world. Notice he's noticing. Notice the husband.
Do you know what she said to me before falling asleep?
Energy.
Leo, we own your DNA.
Listen to what I found.
Jesus, they own my DNA.
This goes back to marriage and water law.
Okay?
The Gotavaranos are one of the oldest families in history. Members of all the world's nobility are in their family tree.
We're screwed.
They believe they descend from mythological figures like Zeus, Kronos, Apollo, Romulus, Remus, Julius Caesar, Cleopatra, the French kings, German emperors, etc.
Darth fucking Vader anywhere in there? The Aryan hybrids.
50% human, 50% alien.
Oh, cool. The ones who rule the world. Now do you understand who we're dealing with?
The ones who rule the world. You can research all this and find out it to be true. Even though this is a science fiction movie.
Zeus?
Never seen a movie that gives this.
Right. Ali, take it easy.
Information that I give on a daily basis.
Ali! Come on, hold it! What the fuck? Jesus! Oh my God! The fuck are you done?
For free. This is my responsibility.
Allez, come on. Le jeu file.
Oui.
Rome, Italy.
Will you please get out?
Why are you doing this? That girl isn't well.
Why are you doing this to us? Why?
I apologize, dear sir, but it's time to go to a much better place.
Oh, God!
Get on your feet now.
Here's the deal. We've got 2 or 3 days max to solve your little problem. Then I, or someone else, will find Saturnia and get her back to her parents.
We're very grateful, Giovanni. But just how did you find out that the French guys were there?
I was already at the location.
Right. You were already at our place. But, well, I mean, why?
Why don't you just light up a nice joint and enjoy the scenery? I don't mind the smoke.
Yeah, cool.
Thanks.
Yeah, cool.
Thanks.
I suppose it would be useless to ask you where you're taking us.
We're meeting Father Trismegistus. He's an exorcist. He can help you.
Exorcist? What?
He's not a regular priest. He left his order. The Jesuits. You get my drift?
Highest priest able to perform an exorcist. Why? Because he knows about all the 13 ghosts. He knows about
great
all
the Lord of the lower world.
Everything he knows you know. But not even.
You're still here.
I was waiting for instructions.
Go on.
Marta.
Betty, come down. Giovanni's here.
So, this is Dr. Pizzo. There's assistance. And the girl is. From now on, you're their guardians.
As you wish.
I put this post up days ago. We're both at the same time, so at
what's
any
her
given
name?
Time, a perking person can be taken
Hexabore.
Possession of.
Hexabore.
That line between being possessed
mm-hmm.
and not.
Cool.
Pay attention. Just like the movie Matrix.
Davide, where did you bring me? Who are these slaves?
There are hosts, Hexabore. We're in their home.
You're wrong, Davide. Hexabore becomes proprietor of wherever Hexabore enters. Which means that those females belong to me.
I have the syringes, grab the heroin.
Knows how to use the word program. This is a simulation. A simulation. Get up your soul, get up your spirit, get your soul. Hashtag free our spirits.
What that thing is.
You should be used to these kind of things, huh, Professor?
Yes, kind of.
Oh, this isn't coming out. Let me get it washed, Father.
Of course, Svetla. You're the boss. You can go now.
I don't know
if you used to vomit. A young person's vomit, but still vomit.
Well, it's not that often I'm thrown up on.
I understand. Or the methods. Hmm?
Notice how creepy these priests are.
Your thesis is astounding.
Notice how creepy.
Soul/energy, demon/aliens who suck the soul/energy from genetically prepared containers.
And how well
if you wanted to destroy the old boundaries between science and religion,
well,
this is an excellent start.
There have never been any boundaries, Father. You know that.
Obviously, just a matter of terminology. Huh?
Yes.
Yes.
This was the only way to put an end to war, to manufacture a being, a container for all of us, and also on a planet that had a good genetic pool. You're the result of all 13 races, but each of the 13 geneticists pushed their own agenda, creating not only what you would refer to as an internal conflict, but also a genetic war, a war without boundaries. But now we've reached the end times, and it is we who triumph. Now you belong only to us. Only to us.
Physically speaking. The Goth of Uranus, black aristocracy, Freemasons, occultists, and Satanists. Saturnia was adopted, or at least she's not the offspring of her father.
I was sure of that.
They'll do anything to get her back, and that includes Hexabor of Ur. It's obvious.
Yes.
Unfortunately, we are not dealing here with simple microchips containing the usual subordinate personalities you normally face. In those kind of rituals, the girl, aroused with drugs and what you will, opens her chakras and voila, the gas gets locked straight into her DNA. And until now, the parasite could manifest itself only occasionally, even if it highly conditioned the container.
And that's where I came in.
Yes, you, with your innovative hypnotic techniques. But in this case, with Saturnia...
Had I known that Saturnia belonged to a family...
You would have done just the same. Even more motivated by curiosity and your desire for knowledge. Well, now. Tonephilos, Father Yorgos, Father Platon.
Hello, Platon.
You sordid pedophile. How are you? He's a Greek. What does he call him? Better qualified than me. In a joking way. Listen, Platon. There's something I think you like.
We have to stop giving her that heroin. I can't keep this up any longer. I keep thinking about my kids with their dog faces.
I'll take care of it. But if we keep on like this, Saturnia's going to come out of this a junkie.
Wait, we could substitute the heroin with N,N-dimethyltryptamine. A lysergic drug might be able to reactivate Saturnia's consciousness. No, that's too risky. What if it reinforced Hexabor? Can you imagine that monster on acid?
We have to find some other way to communicate with the soul. Waveforms, vibrations. I think that that's the right track to follow. By the way,
A magic appeal to the kidnappers from her parents, Prince William and Countess Astrea Goth of Iran.
Wherever you are, I beg you. Our daughter is ill. She suffers from schizophrenia and needs her medical treatment. Please, we are willing to pay any ransom to get her back.
No, Astrea, it'll be all right.
You
are looking at one of the most brilliant exorcists in Eastern Europe, Father Platon.
En to nome de Cristo, diatis tu hematos, disam tu stabludinamus. Viatu Kratus, dis teotitos aptu, diatassusi, demone arnitike, libeton e soma, che li depote di iserde.
Careful not to vilify this container.
Anka komptor opion. Pasa for magia. Pasa puniria. Anda papisto.
Me to touch you there. I'm so ashamed.
That's the guy you called a pedophile. In a joke away. That's how he knew he got professional. He's not 100% pure. He likes little kids.
Platon, you will be the first to be sacrificed.
That's enough.
Why are you pointing that gun at me, Giovanni? What have I done?
Don't try that again, or I'll kill you.
You want to kill your father again?
But Giovanni, you already have killed me. You remember, don't you? Bella coscienza. Ne aspice, ne audi. Bella conscienza.
Exor. You have to give us back Saturnia for a little while.
But I am Saturnia.
Rebella conscienza. Rebella conscienza. Rebella conscienza. Rebella conscienza.
Pagina argomenta.
Rebella conscienza.
An exorcismo reality ereu. Vuoi il you filthy witch!
I've gone over this and I've worked out some numbers. I generated a series of algorithms with one variable. Then I summed them up. When and if Saturnia wakes up, once she goes back home, she'll become a container again. Maybe she'll become the container. Saturnia is the living proof that they can take our soul without being destroyed.
Yes, it makes sense, but...
So, there's no place where she can hide. And there's only one solution. We have to kill her. Eliminate Saturnia now while she's still, hopefully, connected to her soul.
Eleni, you're forgetting one variable, the most important one.
Compassion.
Look, guys, I know it's tough, but the only thing that matters is to bring Saturnia back.
It's an honor to have such a fine scholar by my side. It's something no one has ever done before.
That was not my intention.
You did a miracle, and I'm the living proof of complete incarnation.
Davide, what's the matter? You look terrible. You still having those awful nightmares? Why don't you decide to follow your dear father's example? He gave so much to science. You could have given him such great satisfaction.
Ma.
We had you study in some of the finest religious schools around.
See, Davide? I'm capable of getting rid of cerebral neurotransmitter oxidation. And I could teach you. Would you like me to teach
this battle, my dear?
No. I
against wouldn't. Evil aliens.
I'll tell you anyway.
It's a lost cause.
So, when the beta amyloid.
No.
So, when the beta amyloid.
It's.
I'll tell you anyway.
It's.
So, when the beta amyloid.
It's. It's. No!
Where are these people now, Giovanni?
For Christ's sake.
Israel won't wait much longer.
I lost them during the shooting. How many times do I have to?
How can we be so sure you'll find them before we do?
Yeah, Giovanni. What makes you so sure you'll beat us to the...
Guys, in fact, we're in Rome. Come on. This is my territory. I'm taking care of it.
We're talking with Giovanni. I'll call you back later.
What a beautiful voice. You don't mind if we go upstairs and listen to it, eh?
Do whatever you want. It's probably Betty listening to something.
Hello, Marta. Nice outfit.
Bill, you look great. I missed you.
Marta. Always a pleasure to see you. Especially when you're dressed like that. But right now, I'm more interested in that...
Marta, you don't mind?
Just to be
Just a little orgy between kids. Oi.
Kids? My daughter fell in love with a couple. Any words of advice?
You've brought your daughter up just the way we like it.
They're leaving. You are the result of the 13 races. We are the ones who trial. You are only for us. Fuck.
Okay, here's the plan. We wait for the girl and the professor until Sunday. That's 2 days from now.
You don't know if they're doing it.
This will then become an episode exclusively directed by the Kabbalah Project.
That's how they conjure into their spirit.
Like it.
It's like an antenna. The same way we hold hands.
It's okay.
And pray.
God, Davide.
To our Holy Ghost.
Hey, bro. Forgot my phone.
What do you want?
I'm interested. I decide to stick around. I'll cover for you, my friend. And help you hide the professor and the girl. They can't stay here anymore. Not after what happened tonight.
Hello? I just had some visitors.
Honey.
Yes, it's okay, but not for much longer.
All right.
Tomorrow morning at 8.
Fine.
Those were all Secret Service agents. But the agencies all take their orders from a single source with its own operatives, full autonomy, everything. The Kabbalah Project.
Kabbalah, mysticism. Kabbalah.
The only solution to deal with this kind of possession is in effect to try and reactivate the girl's consciousness and hope the soul will take care of the rest.
That means overriding an entity that at this point is completely integrated. Saturnia's neural network is flooded with hexabore.
I'm quite sure that you also consider virtual the nature of our so-called reality. It's magic made of waves.
Vibrations.
Vibration, exactly. And speaking of which, I might just have an idea. Could you please pass me one of your books?
Ooh.
Any book, as long as it has a barcode. Well, 6.66. Could it be just a matter of decimal points? This is maybe what the Bible is trying to tell us. This is what holds down our consciousness, a frequency. Don't give up, Davide. Hang in there.
I told you, isn't this a nice place?
Fuck off, Matei.
Don't worry about these people, but I promised the boss and old Manusha they could see the girl. It's just a formality. She says a very old spirit has taken control of the girl. There's a witch who lives on a mountain by the Black Sea. Powerful. She can help her. We can take her. In 3 days, we are there.
Are you nuts?
Lab test just came in. Problems. Saturnia is extremely anemic. We need blood. If we don't get ORH negative urgently, she'll die on us.
Giovanni, what are we gonna do?
We have to kill her.
Do you know what this information is that's burning? The formula to cure Alzheimer's.
Father,
go ahead.
Hexabor offered me the solution for Alzheimer's, but I'd have to forget about rescuing Saturnia.
I suggest you make the right decision. Accept it. Accept it.
Accept it.
Abandon your obsolete principles. This life is completely mine. And through it, I can give to you and to all of humanity something truly special. Total knowledge.
Love.
Absolute love.
Hey, Doc. Oh, hurry up. Portofello, I'm waiting for you.
Hey, doctor! They're waiting for you out here.
Dr. Piso, good to meet you. I'm Lieutenant Bruni.
I have some...
ORH negative for you.
Oh, thank you.
We're gonna have to get moving, doctor. Father Trismegistus has organized a little archaeological tour. Giovanni got held up this morning. Seems his presence was requested by the Kabbalah. That's all I know.
I was wondering, why are you risking your job for this?
Several years ago, I took part in an abduction. I was with Milab. An external collection team. I spent the whole time in the van, so I didn't see anything, but I didn't like what was going on.
I know.
What do you know? You know about aliens. But what I saw were men. My own squadron, treating that poor kid like some rag doll. This heavy lead helmet was pulling her head down. Her eyes were rolled back in her head and her mouth was hanging open.
What was that girl's name?
Today, architect, cultural heritage.
There you are. Just be careful, Lieutenant.
Sorry, Doctor, no lights. Do you realize we're now directly under the Imperial Forum?
No. No, I'm not very familiar with this city.
Sector has never been classified. You better hurry.
Can you believe this? An alien formula engraved under the center of Rome. Shit! Because this is a formula, right? I mean...
Well, it looks like the alphabet of Sirius, and since they were the people, the keepers of all technological secrets... Right. It might have to do with
frequencies.
Exactly.
But we need a program to decode it, and we have no internet connection, no cell phone.
Forget it. It's out of the question. What's up?
We need an internet connection to be able to log into intranet sites to decipher it.
Actually, we need ultranet.
We can't connect to anything here.
Betty,
it's Giovanni. Listen to me. Now that we've finally got something to go on, you need to know a few things. The Kabbalah people suspect something's fishy. Yesterday, they gave me an ultimatum. I've got one more day, that's it.
And after that, Dr. Pisa is going to be hell on earth to protect you.
This is like the secretest place in town, guys. This bunch of hackers and musicians came together to form a community. They've got this project, it's so fucking cool, you wouldn't believe it. Just remember though, try not to act too weird.
Yo, Betty.
Hey, professors, we're here.
Super Betty, okay. Welcome to SFR, the project for the search of the frequency of soul. Nice to meet you. JJ Yankee, DJ, technical composer, web prophet. And that's my brother, Doc Enlil, computer maven and problem solver.
Oh yeah, 2 passwords. This is fun. Codes Buster. Version 90. Pakistani stuff, fucking great. It's this program that drives out hidden passwords. I got you now. You're fucked.
There. It's that first one.
Okay. Six, number of the beast. Fuck. Antichrist.
No, that number means 6.66 hertz. It's a frequency.
That's one fucking low frequency.
I need a barcode generator.
One barcode generator coming right up. There.
Okay, wait. Those three bars with no number. Why is there no number? Check what number matches those.
Bars with no numbers. Yeah, how come they don't have numbers?
St. John's Apocalypse. And that no man may buy or sell, save he that had the mark, or the name of the beast. And the number is the name of the beast.
Wait, there has to... How is it possible for a frequency to awaken the soul if it's the same frequency that keeps the soul anchored down? Wait a second. That dash... Fuck, that's a minus sign.
Minus 6.66 hertz. Right, it's a null frequency.
Yes, it's the anti-frequency. Thank you, Trismegistus.
The soul frequency
is an anti-frequency.
Yeah, we gotta delete this frequency from our reality.
That's exactly the key we've been looking for.
But how? How?
We got a frequency generator. What we could do is make it hit 6.66 hertz and jam it through two different channels of the mixer. As you know, if a frequency is not in phase on two channels that are at the same volume, it gets zeroed out, right? So, you got it?
Yes, but the volume would have to be awesome since you can't hear a frequency that low, so it's nearly impossible to counterphase.
Don't even think of using one of our laboratories.
Okay, so when and where can we do it?
We do a rave. An illegal rave. In some deserted place. That's the only way that we have. If you want to keep it secret.
Yeah, it makes sense. Enki and Lil, you're geniuses.
Good boys. But you need to find better security people.
Are you Secret Service agents?
No, no. The professor's not. Davide, one more day. It's all we've got. You have to believe me. We're the good guys.
Yeah, we're not interested in your taxes.
And we really need all the help you can give us.
Surrounding me. It's all transparent. With big, wide open eyes. The serious ones.
Saturnia, I will count to six, and at my six, you'll wake up, and all this will just be. Saturnia!
What we are doing is wrong. Totally wrong, Davide. Saturnia is losing contact.
It's been a while since Hexavore.
We could lose her in another channel.
Took over her personality.
Yes. I'm afraid you're right, but
Saturnia has to be eliminated. And this time, Professor, I include compassion.
We translated the formula. It came out exactly as we thought it would. An ancient formula.
Davide, what's gonna happen to us now, and to everyone else?
There'll be an explosion of energy, which could make this experiment something
a
like...
A million-watt out-of-body experience?
Theoretically, yes, but what we have to do is to nullify that frequency for a couple of seconds in the surrounding area. Doing that, Saturnia's conscience just might wake up and reconnect to her soul.
And eliminate Hexabor. Trismegistus wants to see you about the rave party location.
What's going on?
If you survive this situation, it will be a great pleasure to work with you again, Davide.
I really don't know how to thank you, but our clock is ticking. Those guys are waiting for us to tell them where to go.
Are you familiar with this empty dominion theory postulated by some German scientists?
Yes, empty dominions are like pins of antimatter tacked to different points in the world. Wherever they are, we find basilicas, government offices, brotherhoods, but why are you asking me this?
Where around Rome would you find such a place? This experiment of ours is considered unacceptable by the highest spheres. That inscription I authorize you to photograph is a state secret.
Yes, I know. And I'm grateful.
The vicinity of an empty dominion, and thus an antimatter channel, would allow for the entity's exit, saving it from being destroyed by the reaction of what we call the soul.
It might sound strange, but I never took into consideration that by saving Saturnia, I was going to destroy Hexabor, and he has a body somewhere.
You never wonder who was destroyed every time you saved your abductees. But this is a special case, isn't it? Good. I'm glad we resolved this delicate, interdimensionally political situation. Now think, Professor. Where can we find an empty dominion near Rome?
At Castel Gandolfo Lake.
Nice place for an experiment. Of course, there'll be nobody around guarding the Pope's summer residence.
You're aware you'll have to send in your team.
We're no longer seeing eye to eye with Kabbalah, so it'll be tough involving.
Don't tell them there are problems with Kabbalah, fuckers.
Shit. Jesus. Giovanni, we have to turn the professor over to Kabbalah now.
What?
No, we're here for the experiment. Guys!
Giovanni, call him now. Tell him we're coming.
No, don't you understand that we are going to witness something extraordinary?
I can't. I'm sorry. Did you get it? If we don't hand him over, we're finished. Shit!
Don't believe it! Wait. What if our experiment works? Huh? The three of us! We'd be in charge of any negotiations with world leaders. And you know what that means?
Giovanni, do it now!
Thank you.
Tell me how you found us. What the fuck is going on?
I'll show you. I simply bugged your car.
Fuck you, Mache.
Let's go.
I've done everything I could. But I'm not interested anymore. It's too risky for me now.
I understand. Thank you. Doing. Mate double-crossed us.
And a fine scholar like you, Dr. Piso, you threw away your career to study a phenomenon almost always created by us. Holograms, drugs, hypnosis. It's Hollywood. All in the service of the superior power. now? Where's Hexabor?
You asshole!
Don't make me waste any more time.
Bullshit! This isn't some fucking movie, okay?
Relax. My dear ex-abductee, we just found out that Dr. Pizzo here didn't know you still had a microchip implanted in your brain. The kind used for geographical location? We hold the patent on that. That's how we located you. You know, Doc, we're always finding new, unreachable places to hide in your head.
Lieutenant, it's us. Run, run, move!
Stop! Move!
Don't want to know that you're for Alzheimer's, do you?
No. No.
Antonia, listen to me. It's time for you to walk back out of that screen you're in. At MI6, you'll be with us again. Soul, answer, answer.
parasitic being has taken over this girl's body to use your energy.
It probably needs it.
Of course, but...
we're here to play, and anyone can use our energy.
But this being and others similar to it, want to keep you locked up and imprisoned. And keep your power all for themselves. And you won't be able to play anymore. So, since you can go into the future, go see how all this will end.
Yes, sir. There are about 50 kids here. And they're all asleep. Yes, sleeping. And there's been a little bloodshed. Mm-hmm. We lost Bill and some of his men. And you know what we found them with? The bodies of 3 soldiers. Italian soldiers. Oy vey.
Make it about a week. Better to be on a safe side.
No. Not him.
Why not? What's so special about him?
Orders from upstairs. Someone wants his memory intact.
And of course we can't let that someone down.
Mm-hmm.
Help me.
little princess is coming home. Unfortunately, without her guest. The police should be getting here any moment now. We're taking the girl to the farmhouse in the north of Rome with the bodies of the three Italian soldiers. Yes, it'll make a great story.
With a reminder about our brotherhood's final goal, which is to unite people who have a soul. Together, we will find an autonomous way of living a better life in this world by the use of our talents and of our minds. That's why we came here in a state of conflict.
Because it's a challenge.
So that we could find a way of living in freedom, as in heaven, so on earth. Excitatio anima, minus 6.66 hertz. This will be our secret.
Justin, a combined effort by the police and armed forces resulted in the discovery and rescue of the Countess Saturnia Gotha Verano, who had been kidnapped 6 days ago. The young girl was found in an abandoned farmhouse on the outskirts of Rome after a bloody shootout with the kidnappers, in which three courageous members of the armed forces' advance guard lost their lives.
A terrorist cell with the stated aim of acts of destabilization in this country is taking credit for the kidnapping, although experts believe the new group has probable connections with the jihad.
The kidnapping of Saturnia Gotha Verano is the latest in a long line of terrorist acts, signals of a state of instability and unrest in this country as well as in all of Europe. But now, thanks to the collaborative efforts of the U.S. and Israel, officials can finally guarantee the population.
The use of the new subcutaneous microchip will make it easier for the authorities to maintain control of the population in their fight against terrorism.
Thank you. Thank you so very much. We're so grateful for the brilliant job of finding her. Saturnia suffered